Life expectancy currently stalled in the OECD is influenced by rising income inequality. So, with a high possibility of a negative effect on jobs by COVID-19, it seems counterintuitive to suggest the pandemic will lead to longer lives. But new research by UBS shows how long-term health positives triggered by the coronavirus crisis could more than counterbalance the negatives over time. Government spending on health tech is likely to be prioritized post-pandemic, with its pivotal performance in 2020 pointing to powerful potential. AI helped China and Korea track, trace, and tame the outbreak early on. And AI's ability to process vast amounts of unstructured data should accelerate future drug development. Blockchain could help track the spread of a disease, optimize patient medical data, and maintain more sustainable medical supply chains. Telehealth should improve the sorting of patients before they arrive at hospital, limiting contact with medical staff. At scale, 3D printing of parts for personal protective equipment and medical equipment should accelerate speed to market and lower production costs. How long before drones detect symptoms in crowds and robo-taxis drive infected patients to hospital? And the COVID Genome Database suggests open source tech could fuel the build of new databases and harness data to tackle societal challenges. Obesity is putting significant pressure on future life expectancy and GDP growth in OECD countries. And given the link between rising income inequality and obesity, there is a real chance a sustained hit to the labour market would increase obesity rates. But the clear link between obesity and mortality, highlighted by coronavirus, will likely shift government policy from treatment to prevention. Health tech and government policy are important, but perhaps the most significant factor driving higher life expectancy will be much better engagement by people in their own health. There is early evidence that attitudes are shifting fast. With no alternative to cooking and exercising at home, we ate more vegetables and lifted more weights in lockdown. This is a passive choice, necessitated by circumstances, and may tail off in the coming months. But UBS believes the soaring demand for vitamins and the drop in smoking indicate a more active consumer pivot to a healthier lifestyle might stick. Longer, healthier lives lead to greater labour supply and more consumer demand. UBS's stock coverage analysts saw this as the most positive among seven megatrends that they analysed. Downsides depend on when we retire, cautions UBS. If we get older but we don't work for longer, the financial sector may suffer. Saving levels may be forced higher as people worry about future income. Rates will likely remain very low, hurting banks and pushing pension funds into riskier assets. Conversely, health tech and e-commerce are the standout winners in a longer living world. The two other key beneficiaries? Leisure and real estate, particularly senior housing REITs. As the population ages, expenditure on leisure, healthcare, and housing increases. So if you have a long-term horizon, this may be the wrong time to give up on that cruise liner stock.